Hey, what's up guys? This is Vincent, and in this Lightroom Classic tutorial, I'm going to show you how to export photos from the Lightroom Library module. So there's a few ways to export photos. The easiest way is selecting a few images and clicking on this export button. So you can export one image, or you can export multiple images. To select multiple images, just shift-click on them. And you can also add individual images by pressing Control-click or Command-click. In this case, I'm just going to select these five photos at the top, and then I'll click Export. And then a pop-up will come up with a few options. There's these preset options, which we won't be adding. And here you'll be able to choose where you want to export your images to. So right now I'm going to just export it to my desktop. You can put it in whichever folder you want to. And depending on how many photos you have, you may want to put it in a subfolder. So I'll just put these five photos in a subfolder. I'll just name it Lightroom Tutorial and existing files. You ask it what Lightroom will ask you what you want to do if there's like duplicate names. File naming, you can rename it to a custom name if you want. Let me just put it here. Let me just put tutorial just to give you an example. You can skip this. File settings is pretty important. Most of the time, you want to export your photos as JPEG and keep the quality at 100. Color space, sRGB is usually the best option for printing as well as displaying your photos online. Depending on the printing company, they may give you a different color profile or color space to print your photos at, but usually sRGB is the best option. Image resizing, you may want to do this just for SEO purposes and limit the weight, the sorry, limit the width and the height. Usually for landscape photos, I limit the long edge. So I'll usually like limit it to like 1,000 or 2,000 pixels, but in this case I won't limit the size. For resolution, most of the time 72 is good for images that are displayed online, and 300 pixels per inch is usually the best option for prints. But you should double check with the printing company or the printer. And output sharpening, I usually don't apply any output sharpening because I do all of that in the develop module of Lightroom when I'm editing. So you'll see that later on. You can include or keep the metadata, including like the camera exposure, the shutter speed, the ISO settings, and the aperture if you want. And this information will be tagged or included in the image file. And now watermarks. Lightroom allows you to add a simple watermark if you want. You just put your name here or whatever you want to write. And then just make sure you reduce the opacity to something that's a little bit more aesthetic. So here it is, and then you can move it around if you want to the watermark. But the best thing to do for a watermark is create a custom watermark using a PNG file and then loading it into Lightroom. So you can use like Canva or Photoshop or some logo making company to create a watermark for you. But it's pretty easy. You shouldn't have to pay to create your own watermark. Just try out Canva. They have a lot of good free options. I'll put a link in the description. But other than that, the watermarks are pretty easy. I'll just click Save. Oh, I now have to rename this preset, so I won't apply a watermark in this case. And after this, it's all set. And I'll just click on Export. Actually, wait, after Export, I'll show the folder. And okay, so I just clicked on export, it's exporting, and here are the photos. And remember, I renamed the photos tutorial, so the files have been renamed. And here is the main folder on my desktop. So that's pretty much it for the export settings or the export tool. It's pretty easy to use, there's a lot of options, but just to make it quick, just export your files in JPEG. And depending on, and if you're a professional photographer and you want to save or copyright your images as well as keep the EXIF or metadata, you may have to tweak the export settings. Other than that, if you guys enjoyed this video, give it a like, subscribe, and follow me on Instagram. Have a good one.